Yeah, I control the saw in every way. I'll show you. Bring over my next log. Set that taper. Pin it to win it. Flip it. Taper it again. Hammer down some more. Flip it again. Bring the next log over. Hammer down some more. Send the cant down to my resaw guy. He'll keep cutting them. Normally I just take four boards, one off each side. I told you, full throttle. Joystick till it stops. Yeah, we've been running this for the whole week. And we'll keep on running it until it's gone, probably. Our inventory is real high out there in the yard. At least a 6 foot board, at least 4 to 5 inches wide after it's been edged and end trimmed. Fogarty. music guru dream.
Idea. I love the idea of going to the UK or taking rides.
the stickers.
Is that what it sounds like?
We don't sticker much lumber. We sell it all green.
Earthquake debris to find the human life if aliens survive. So, I mean, it's kind of cute, but again, it's a rat. And think of yourself under a pile of rubble after an earthquake. You see a rat.
To do this job well,
camera the whole thing.
It's best to know what defects look like. Have a good basis of what grade of the logs or the lumber is. Pay attention. Yeah, the next day you're like, what was all that sparks and that explosion? Like, I don't know, the blade just decided to turn all by itself.
Here's another 8-quarter log, I hope.
idea who sings this song. I'm not sure what the going rate for ash logs are. I know what the lumber prices are for the high grade, mid grade, and low grade. But that's completely different in log form. Yeah, I control the saw going back and forth and how thick to cut the lumber. Like I see, this face has no defects, so I'm going straight into my 8-quarter set. Make a nice piece of high-grade 8-quarter here. See, it's so clear on the back. That's gonna sell for $180 a foot. Rough. Now this stupid little log is probably free. So fucking crooked. I mean freaking crooked. Sorry to the Bible thumper. savvy on this TikTok shit. I just hit go live and start throwing logs. We do usually about 25 to 30,000 board feet a day if we have decent sized logs. Log 302, by the way. Do I own the mill? No. I just work here. But I'm what you call a senior employee. Started at the bottom, worked all my way to the top. Any of my money yet. I haven't even checked my balance in a long, long time. I only get like a couple dollars a day, I think, from all the gifts. A couple weeks ago, I checked my balance. I couldn't even find out where they moved the balance to. Back up, shut that off, floor it. back. Flip it again. That's how I missed most of the comments. New York. that long. What hours do y'all work? We work 4 10-hour days for running production from 6 a.m. till 5. Half hour for lunch, half hour for cleanup. Normally I'd pull some 8-quarter off this log, but my resaw guy, he's down. All that fuckery we just had with that stupid log. Whoop, I cursed again, sorry.
This next package came out last year. Something to get us through isolation and lockdown. We were going through at the time, working at home. And it's just simply called Flavor Jack Live. This recording is from Hopefully Kyle Steele.
Yeah, I find that a lot of my viewers have worked at a sawmill. It's pretty awesome. Mm-hmm. Back when people knew how to work. Oh, that's a crooked one. I should be showing the new guy how to handle a log like this that's all crooked. I don't know if he knows. Hey there, how are you? Well, we don't really saw too much unique stuff. Most of just your average run-of-the-mill hardwood. Maple, oak, cherry, walnut, ash, hickory, butternut, beech, birch, sometimes black locust. I think I named them all. Oh yeah, basswood and poplar. Those aren't very unique though, they're pretty shitty. Yeah, there's a lot of tension in ash. Yeah, cherry gets a lot of nice character sometimes. Butternut, we usually let that sit around out in the yard until it's almost rotten for some reason. We don't get a lot of it, that's why. But I like butternut. I built a coffee table. There's a video in my content. Real nice stuff. That's why we make 8-quarters so you can build tabletops. If you see in my content, I made a dresser and a bed all out of black walnut and curly maple from scrap that I brought home. Yeah, I do custom woodworking myself. No, no gum. Yeah, if you like walnut, check out some of my content. I do a bunch of cutting boards, bread boxes. I've done a couple different beds for my own house, dressers. I just did a live edge maple TV stand. That pit in the middle and out of the lumber. go through this edger, if it has rough edges on it, or it goes to this trim saw and it gets trimmed to length, and then it gets graded and stacked up. For furniture, maybe some cabinets or flooring, depends on where it goes after the kiln dries it. Our customer that dries the lumber is a big lumber broker, so I'm sure it could go just about anywhere. Got a little bit of a split to deal with on this one. Hopefully the edger guy knows how to deal with it. Make a skinny board, a little bit of weight. A 100 years ago, they were probably using circle saws. That becomes wood chips right there. Then this becomes a board. It'll get sent through that edger. It'll be like 4 inches wide. And so on. Alright, who sings this one? How many legs do you cut a day? I'm at 312 now. We got about a half hour left. Controls are this joystick with a bunch of buttons, this joystick with a bunch of buttons, all these buttons, and this is a touchscreen, a couple pedals on the floor. Yeah, Clapton, you got it. Deck's 40 inches, so that's as big as the log we could even fit in the building. Now, there's not really much hazardous about this. This is like half-inch plate plexiglass that I'm looking through. Right on the dot, man. Right on the dot. Here he is. Hopefully for all these 16-footers, I don't feel like sawing anymore.
Yeah, that's good to
know. They look straight at me.
Yeah, wait for straight.
Like I said, just work your way around it. Try not to hit the pith on anything. When you get to like that 4.6 or like 4.7, whatever it is, where you're one board away from 3.6. Boot it off.
How wide do you normally try making the small teeth? Around 6, 5, or 6?
Yeah, around 5, 6. Like if the heart's going back and forth, I don't even bother worrying about making it skinny. You can find a way to keep the fifth out of the board and get down to that 4.5 and have it be a shim away from being done, and that's all I leave them at. I just try not to leave a good board without the pin in it on the side.
Keep your ops on my techniques and told them that I'd have you help them with like the racing pole.
Yeah.
Because obviously you know a lot more about it. I mean, I know fairly what I need to know for it.
Yep.
There's a lot more you can teach than I could.
Yep. Throw some earplugs in and I noticed yesterday at the end of the day he was wearing earplugs like that. Let's see if I can do some training here.